Hello everyone, this is StalinRuSH, and we're actually starting a new series, another Elder Scrolls series, because you guys seem to have loved it. And I got suggested by somebody something about a cow, and yeah, sorry I don't remember your name. I'm really, really bad with names, but they suggested that I play Pariah, Piran, yep, Piran. And we're going to play as a quote-unquote immortal person. We are going to be the king, yes. Hyphen Organum. We are independent, we're Mormir, and we're Pyodonic. Let's check it out. Religious, yeah, Pyodonic. We got some Ipysurin, some Orphidian cult religions in there. We're all Mormir. So we will actually play as this, because apparently we are undying? Not entirely sure, but we'll give it a shot. It'd be interesting trying to get off this island, that's for sure. Maybe we'll go up to okay. I Organum the Immortal. Well, that's a good sign. The once and future king of Pyodonia will rise again to power. The defeat of my armies, led by an incompetent, has broken my hold over the High Kingdom, but my wealth is great and my powers are greater. Continue, okay? These rebellious curs who now call themselves kings in my land will feel my wrath, and Pyodonia will rise again from the sea. And when I sit upon my throne once more, I will turn my sights to that corralled land across the sea, and Olenor shall tremble once more. Peladonia will be mine once again. I get a strong claim on Kingdom of Abaras, Pontu, and Pyodonia. Alrighty then. Let's see. So we have all this. None of that is a problem. They are not allied with anybody. Not allied with anybody, and not allied with anybody. Alrighty then, let's check out our stats and everything. So we are currently 3,367 years old. Okay. Wow. So we are Pyodonic. Religious head is Hyphen Organum, which is me. The religious and cultural practices of the Mormir, as laid down and for millennia, led by the God King Organum. God King. Oh my god, that's awesome. Last of the Aldemiri, the race of Tyrannimic Mac, and R.L. R.E.L. They follow what they believe to be the original Aldemiri traditions and beliefs as interpreted by Organum and the six schools of Pyodonic philosophy. Their primary gods are El, Tyrannimac, Arnui El, Magnon, Syrabane, Meridia, and Organum. Wow. Okay then. Talk about trying to make me pronounce things. This is King Tanan of Pontu. Don't think he counts as being a god. He's only 200 years old. He's not even close. Not even close. How about you? You are 170. You are 152. Yeah, they ain't me. Alright, so we are a master mage. We are Mormir. We're also known as sea elves or tropical elves. Our race of Myr that reside on the island of Pyodonia, south of the continent of Tamriel. We get a martial and intrigue, lose a diplomacy, and fertility is down. Seems that we're undying, that's not an issue, I suppose. So we got Organum's Coffer. King Organum's Coffer is a small-sized chest, ordinary in appearance. It is remarkably light, almost weightless, which offers a clue to its true magic. Once a day, the coffer will create gold from naught. When King Organum himself possesses the coffer, the supply within was limitless. So, alright. Monthly wealth is plus 12 ducats monthly. Sweet. Orgnum bloodline. Orgnum, the wizard king. The god king, the immortal, ruled Pradonia as a personified deity for millennia after his failed insurrection against his Aldemir overlords. His ambition knew no bounds, and thanks to his magical coffers, neither did his wealth. So, we get 0.07 monthly prestige and another learning. We're also attractive as character, the most pleasing physique, most attractive to the opposite sex. Nice. Let's blow up Machine 30 attraction. Opinion? Okay. Immortal, his character is so powerful that he may outlive the gods themselves. I have, no fertility. Mystic, this character has divulged in the mystery of the occult, treading on the fine line between heresy and orthodox approval. I'm ruthless, envious, ambitious, and craven. Well, that sucks, but we have a 6, 7, 12, 21, 23, so we are really mage-ish. That's crazy. So, we don't seem to have any factions. We can, plot, of course. Religious, factions, religion, alright. Yep, we went over this. Doesn't look like there's any modifying. We need to take back our holy sites. So, how is our military? Can we have any retinues? We can't just yet. We have about 960 men. A little lowish. Seems that we're a god king. And royal laws of Paran? Yeah. But we're never going to die, so succession doesn't really matter, right? So, the Prince Albaran of Valas is my lover. Are we homosexual as well? Because I guess I got two lovers. Yep, I'm pretty sure I'm homosexual. But, oh well. Not like it's a huge deal. Alright, let's check out our vassals. Not many people like me, but I guess there's not many people to have liked. Open council vision. Oh, magistrate. Oh, we literally don't have anyone. Alright. Set our guys to improve diplomacy, train troops. Here. Well, that technically would have been the wrong choice, but oh well. We'll collect taxes and scheme, make sure we don't die. And our ambition is get married, of course. What is it anything else? So we have a lot to choose from. We can either choose her, or we can choose her. We got a lot of money, and we get money come from our magic coffers. So why not hire a debutante? Let's see. Appointment list? Yeah. Stewardship, yep. President debutante. She's absent-minded. Well, okay, so she's bad, is what she's telling me. So I can't actually hire another one. That's awful. So, alright, so titles can be claimed, loss, and succession. Still need a magistrate. Really? You're just not going to let me have one? Alright. Whatever, be that way. And, alright. Let's see how our neighbors look for power. They're currently sporting 344. And we can beat that, right? Yes, we definitely can. But let's like, who has the most power in the realm besides us? This person. He is Baron Balron of Kotolgdur. Alright, here. So we will actually choose our Chancellor to improve relations there. Because this way he'll at least give us more men. Hopefully. Could definitely do some plotting. Button. Cancel this out. Let's look at our laws real quick. Alright. Didn't look anything out of the ordinary from last time we played, but We have some things down here. Legalize Orgrin Ruxares. Clear that Orgrin is a legitimate gen, that bastard. Oh, I see. So let's look at our family right now. So we have a daughter. She's genius attractive. She's also a tyrant. Deceitful, fashionable, got our bloodline. Okay, so obviously they're our child because they have our bloodline. And this one's strong attractive. But he's also dishonorable and a slob. Interesting, interesting. We'll let a couple of days pass by, see if we can get any more marriage options. The interregnum. Yep, we know this is. Ah, skip. Kind of wanted some good traits. I wanted more stewardship, that's what I wanted. The Lords of Plundra have approved the institution of Mineral Crown Levy. Alright, duh. I need a haircut. Nothing like a haircut to solve your problems. Yes. Could be a drill head. Ah, we'll go with that cut. I just got this whiskey beard that I'm just gonna keep. I know I now have the steed birth sign. The steed shall speed my crosses on the road of destiny. Excuse me. Here goes my throat. My family is important to me. I should love my family. Okay, then. That's, you know, definitely true. We should get married, though. 7, this one's a little bit better. Yeah, we'll take her. Apparently I can't. Okay. She already got snatched up. Well, that's a bunch of crap. Fingers of a saint. Discount prices for boxes of 10. The bishop brings to your attention that false relics are being sold at the marketplace for great profit. Blah, blah, blah. Yep, we know this one. So we can gain some favor. Crack down on these criminals. Leave them be. Or get in on the business. Well, we only lose a little bit of ducats, so yeah. We have a bit of Magica, the church approves. Prisoners, we don't have any, but let's open minor title decisions. Minor title auto assign. It's been a while since I've played any Elder Kings, so gotta remember how to go through all this stuff. Well, we should be able to get a lot of spell power, so we'll let that just kind of build up for now. Make an offering. Display Dragonborn. Of Sirebane is pleased with your offer. Well. Well, we'll hold off on that. Because right now, we're just going to want to go to war. Oops, that's not the right one. Yeah, so they are still less than me. All right, time to go to war. So declare war. Claim all of it. I think I'm gonna claim all of it for Baron Agnes of Falls, your vassal. I don't think so. Or maybe I will. Worst case scenario, I just have to go to war with him also. Till I take everything. Baron, one of the following must be true. Okay, so we can't. Have to take it by pieces, huh? Alright, we'll take this one. And we'll raise up all the men. Oh, that music is so good. But, can we have a magistrate yet? No. Guess I'm gonna have to hire someone? Of an employment list. Chancellor, Spy Master, Hire Mage. Done. Alright, so now we should be able to hire, reuse one, right? Point. Yep, this guy. One is better than none. Alright, so, War Magic. Your Magic will be dispatched to the target province to boost its troop with their battle magic, and to recruit new War Mages to your cause. It's not bad. approves magic relations. You have a magister that leads academic delegations to discuss matters of magic with the local priests and wizards. And what are we doing for religion? I guess we could proselytize here. No, we can't. So, really? We're kind of just good. So improve medical relations with them, I suppose. It's irrelevant to me personally, so. Hire a debutante. Done. Close. Still need to get married. 7. It's about as good as it's gonna get, I guess. Goddamn slobs. Ooh, we got some agile. We're gonna take the possibility of getting more stats, I guess. Oh, whatever, send. We live forever, so it's not gonna be a problem. I got married and my family grows. I love my wife, my in-laws, not so much. High organum, blah blah blah. Money, prestige for sure. Okay. Fulfilled ambition, good. Next, we will. What? Undertake pilgrimage, obtain an artifact. We just have the one artifact, so we should probably get some, but. Improve diplomacy. That's breaking up virtue. It's favor at least 500, huh? Well, that might be a while. Let's improve martial ability. Yeah. But I don't know what it's gonna be like when we are undying. Might be interesting. 70 is our daughter, and well, I guess since they're twins, they're probably both going to be 70. That's just a random guess. It's not really random. It's just how it is. Alright, get crushed. Scrubs. You rebel in my land. I have become afraid that someone might want to hurt me. I am thinking about hiring two food testers, and maybe a bodyguard would be a good idea. Food testers, bodyguards, isn't can save me. Gain straight paranoid, huh? Marshal Prince Elbaran told me about his ideas. I couldn't really understand what he's talking about, but he was adamant in his belief that this would improve the military. Adapt his ideas? For sure. Doesn't look like we gain paranoid, so. Let's wipe them out first. Na-na-na. Dragonborn discovered by Magnus Myra Kamir of North Road is the Dragonborn. Beware, beware, the Dragonborn comes. Your wife, in her loneliness of longing for a child, has decided to purchase a cat from one of the scullery maids using money from your coffers. She needs the company. Or I can gain some prestige. Eh, she can have a cat. I don't mind. It's not too bad to have a familiar. My peasant attacked me while collecting the taxes. How dare they? Alright, let's go take the preferred area and just kind of go from there. So we have problems already, huh? Interesting. But, nothing too interesting. No heir to my dynasty. Well, I hope I have a wife then. A wife. Child then, huh? Our wife is 17. May as well be a newborn. I am thousands and thousands of years older than her. Thousands and a thousands. Well, we can have we have 10 magic, so we should probably use some of it so we can recharge. Spellbook. What do we do? I don't even know. Cost 25 Magicka. Alright, well, maybe 25 isn't the max. Learning with a maximum of 60 at learning 30. So we have plenty more to go. Alright, never mind. So we'll just let it happen. Should be able to take this fairly fast. But, come on, scroll back up. There you go. Thank you. But, shouldn't be too bad, and I think once we take all this, which it should be straight up since they don't have any alliances, really. We should go to Alnor and then on to Tamriel, which is a cluster of nonsense. And offer peace and force demands. Yay! Land is now ours! And we still have quite a bit more dominions that we could possibly take. So what? That's all the proper religion too. So we will keep it. Done. Alright. He's now still hating on me. Like the scumbag that he is, apparently. So can we declare war on this guy? Could. Inquisition. Well, we could take more because of it. Not that we can do it, so I guess never mind. Conquest. We'll probably do conquest, to be honest. Let's make sure he doesn't have too many men. 600, huh? Well, we'll let this replenish just a little bit. But, since that we just started this episode, I think we'll end it with just kind of going over everything, and it's just mild attacking. But, I'm thinking about, assuming I can upload fast enough, that I'll probably try to do, like, an episode every other day. Kind of the opposite of my EU4 campaign that we're doing right now, the Manchurian Candidate thing. So, that's what I'm going to try to do. So, every 2 days we'll have an episode. So, if you guys liked the episode, please hit the like button. Help out a ton. Drop a comment. Having comments and knowing what everybody thinks on the first episode is always really good for me. Letting me know that people actually want to watch this. I had pretty good luck with the last series, and you guys all seem to think so too. So, I hope you guys enjoy it. So, I'll see you guys next time. Alright, goodbye.